Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2021 Mayor's State of the City Address. This will be somewhat different than we've had in the past number of years, mainly because of COVID and its impact upon all of us. What we have here is going to be a virtual presentation that has finally been realized, of course, by the fact that we tried the Masonic Lodge, can't have that. We were going to use the Esplanade, can't have that. And now here we are. But it's taken a little bit of work and cooperation. And I'd like to thank the people who have helped put this together. First of all, there's Sandy Seaford and John from the Kiwanis Club, Kristen Wallace from the Chamber of Commerce, and Colleen Graham from the City of Medicine Hat, plus our capable and competent David G, who was Sean Cable and putting this all together. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be different, as I say, but you will get the same kind of impression from it and the same kind of impact, because the Kiwanis Club, in cooperation with the Chamber of Commerce, is very, very pleased to present this annual address by the mayor. But let us now stand, if we can, and listen to O Canada, sung to us by, sung for us, I should say, by Randy Ferry, our dulcet community singer. Randy, take it away.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you very much, Randy. It's always a pleasure to listen to you. And I know that the people who are registered to listen with us today at this annual event appreciate your singing. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Derek Ironside, the president of the Kiwanis Club of Medicine Hat, to provide our invocation.
Thank you, Dr. Sauer. Before I begin, I would like to express my thanks to the organizing committee for giving me the task of delivering the invocation. I feel very privileged and humbled to be granted this honor for this extremely important event. Let us pray. As each of us gives our own thanks according to our personal beliefs and traditions, it is good to recognize how different we are, our talents, our dreams, our backgrounds, our occupations, as well. Heavenly Father, it is good to know that when you created each of us, you broke the mold. No one person is exactly like anyone else. Even our thumbprints and our voice tracks tell us how unique we are. We thank you that we can take these differences and mobilize them for the good of Kiwanis and our community. In our differences, we can still think the same thoughts and move together towards a common goal. Please bless us and look over us as we meet together, yet we are still far apart. Thank you for our individuality and also for our common bond. Amen. Thank you, and let us proceed.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to once again introduce His Worship Mayor Ted Clugston, the mayor of Medicine Hat, who has been our guest for the last 7 years at the annual Mayor's State of the City Address. Now, Ted and I go back some time, of course, and we have crisscrossed our paths down at the police point of our pathway. We have met at various other occasions. He has been always been a very, very good for the Kiwanis Club by coming out to our best block and best residence. And just generally, takes a lot of pride in this community. But ladies and gentlemen, I must just do a little sidewalk kick here and warn the mayor that I have been giving a great consideration to running for office as mayor this fall. But then after some serious consideration, I decided to defer my decision until 2046. And by that time, you will have forgotten who I am and all is safe. So ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure again, as I say, to introduce to you His Worship Mayor Ted Clugston.
Good afternoon, and thanks for watching. In past years, I have always enjoyed meeting you at the door and shaking your hands and talking to as many of you as possible. Of course, we can't do that this year. And I just want to thank you in the past for graciously attending this event. I really miss that. However, this year, we have had the opportunity to pre-record this video, which allows us to do more pre- and post-production. So I hope you find this format a good alternative given the times we are in. I'd like to thank Colleen, Tim, and Ashley for your patience and professionalism helping me put this together. This year, I will present in three sections. I'd like to talk about the year that was and wish it a hearty good riddance. However, many positive things were accomplished. Then move on to 2021 and the things that we have to look forward to. And then I intend to announce my decision regarding the upcoming municipal election this October. So obviously I can't speak about 2020 without mentioning COVID. At the very beginning of the pandemic, I must admit I was spooked. And I was spooked by the modeling of all the cases and deaths that were projected. And what would my role be in this uncharted territory? I had people literally losing their minds in utter panic. People that I had seen be strong and stoic during other events, but were having a difficult time maintaining their composure during this event. I leaned on the first line of If, the poem by Rudyard Kipling during the beginning. I would say to myself, Ted and council, if you can keep your head when all around you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you and make allowance for their doubting too. I also thought of my father and how he would handle this situation if he were alive today and in my shoes. And it helped to give me some comfort and strength to get through the early days of the pandemic. We are going to play a video from the very early days of the pandemic to remind people of just how far we have come. Thank you. I'd like to thank Colt McKeefe for allowing us to use that video. I am so thankful and proud of the City Council you elected during this term. They were steady, under pressure, and were, in my opinion, the only council in the province of Alberta that did not panic. We went to work. We worked at the problem. No placebo local state of emergency, a useless declaration during a global pandemic, and wow, were we ever criticized. We were proven correct with time. The city's approach to the pandemic was, we set up an incident command post, it was activated, and Merrick Brown has been council's trusted advisor since the early days. We knew we had to continue to deliver essential services, and nothing would make this worse than the power going out or a boil water order or our entire fire services going down with the disease. Safety has always been our number one priority. We tried our best to support AHS in their decisions and assist in repeating and repeating the messages as often as possible through all sorts of media. We did weekly media updates and press conferences, and we tried to support AHS with the restrictions and help them to communicate them. However, we tried to use education and personal civic responsibility versus the big stick approach. I cannot thank the frontline workers enough, police, fire, power, water, sanitary, sewer, solid waste, the fire chief, police chief, everyone on the front lines. I also can't thank my senior staff enough through all of this. Many dealing with their own health issues and perhaps fears. Brian Mastel, Stan Schwarzenberger, Brad Maines, and Dennis Egert. I have been at City Hall every day since the beginning of this pandemic. And there has been one person who I've probably leaned on the most and who has been by my side through all of this, and that would be Bob Nicolay, the CAO of the city. Thank you, Bob. Council showed great resolve and a sense of innovation during the early days. We introduced the Medicine Hat Big Grant, and with $2 million going to our local small businesses to help them to adapt and to that new word that we all started using in 2020 to help them pivot. We halted all tax increases, no tax increases for 2020 and 2021. We put money into community warmth to help those struggling with utility bills and delayed property tax collection and utility collection. On a per capita basis, I believe no major municipality has done more than the City of Medicine Hat. Many even had to raise property taxes or even borrow money to keep the lights on and their employees paid. Something, and borrowing money from municipalities is something that they are prohibited to do for operational expenses. I think most of you would agree that our small businesses have been hit extremely hard during COVID. We'd like to show you a video that celebrates the success of some of our small businesses and how they were able to pivot.
Stressful.
How am I going to make it? How long is it going to be?
I was actually scared.
I was getting ready for the busiest time of the year.
Well, this should be short-lived. We shouldn't have any problem.
There was a lot of uncertainty.
Do I have enough saved up?
It was something that was new and I had never experienced anything like that in my life.
The way I run my business is you never look backwards. You always go forward. There might be a hurdle in front of you, but you just keep going forward. And so, and how do I rewrite this? How do I survive? How do I keep what's good in Medicine Hat alive? And can we make it any further?
We focused on our online store and we started to offer free local delivery too. So we would actually take our online orders and then bring them to people's houses here in Medicine Hat.
I adapted by starting an online website. So we created a Shopify account so people could shop online. We offered doorstep deliveries.
We just jumped into gear right away, contacted all our teachers and said, guys, we are hopping online.
It was time to take care of our students, our parents and our teachers and just keep on working, just keep on going.
We gave all of our members and our instructors the equipment. We had sort of a rental program of sorts. My husband and I actually drove around and we delivered benches and weights all over town. We spent a whole day doing that. We went completely online.
Thank you.
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 I would like to thank the small business community for the resilience.
For being the backbone of commerce and community.
For everything that you've had to overcome over the last several months.
For your effort, energy, and passion.
For being the major job creators in our community.
For staying resilient over these tough times.
You have shown great courage to take risks.
This community truly appreciates it.
Small businesses are the biggest employer in Medicine Hat.
You are the lifeblood of our community.
Thank you to all the small business of our community.
I cannot thank you enough.
I am just so honored to be part of a community that has been incredibly resilient, incredibly creative, and always finding ways to evolve and to identify these challenges and to rise above. On behalf of Invest Medicine Hat and the City of Medicine Hat, we thank you for your contributions and investment to this community.
We're extremely grateful for all of our existing clientele and customers.
The parents and the students, no one flinched.
Missed how was amazing for trying to support local.
People are really trying to support us and small businesses.
They stuck with us.
Yeah, that's awesome. The best part about it.
So thank you to everyone who participated in that video. Some things did not go well for our community. Our community demonstrated a great deal of resilience, but there were some terrible times and scars that we will carry forever. While COVID was the lead story on every media platform across the country, the world, and locally, we had a devastating string of suicides. I was personally touched many times and I lost many friends and acquaintances. These young men and women chose to take their own lives, and I don't want them to be forgotten. While I initially wanted to reject the request from CBC for an interview, as I didn't want Medicine Hat to be known nationally as the place where young men and women feel there is no other option than to take their own lives. But I felt I needed to do the interview, as we needed to have the conversation about mental health and why men and men like myself don't want to talk about it. Here's the video that was produced by CBC and in my opinion, is an exceptionally well done.
Right. Thought I had a little bit of a perspective about suicide survivors, the impact, and I didn't have a clue. Because the devastation is so profound. And it's just a gigantic ripple effect on everybody.
You don't even want to open up your Facebook feed some days because you're going to see, you know, there's another one today. There's another one today. And then it's who? Who is it? What happened? Five, six, seven young men.
Wives and mothers and sisters and other friends, they're white knuckling right now. We're in sort of this experience of a contagion. Suicidal contagion. There's an immense fear about who's next right now. Everybody's walking on pins and needles, holding their breath.
So many questions and so much guilt in our community, and it's just like a desperation. You just wanted to stop because you understand the pain and you don't want anyone else to feel it.
On May 29th, my brother took his life. My brother Brandon. And it was out of nowhere. We don't really know what happened because he didn't even know.
Yeah, it was 2 months after one of his best friends passed away. Ryan actually passed away the day of another friend's funeral. So we were at a
a celebration of life or whatever you want to call it the night before.
It was a buddy of mine, and this is the same theme you'll hear from all of these. They were the light, you know, life of the party. They're the guy that walked in and everybody stopped and wanted to talk to, and some of them seemed to have everything in the world, businesses and, families and wives and kids. And so it's hard to get your head around.
We were barely trying to heal and recover from his friend passing. And we had spoke about suicide a lot because of that. He had promised me that this was something that would not happen. And I think in that moment, he truthfully did mean that and believe that. I was the one to find him, and his parents thankfully live next door. So I had their support, and we were there together for that traumatic experience. I truly believe that Ryan didn't want to die. In that moment, he made a quick, impulsive decision because he was sad and overwhelmed, and he'd been drinking. It's nothing I could ever have imagined. But the subsequent ones, it's just kind of reliving that trauma, and I've barely had a chance to catch my breath, and then you keep hearing of things happening, and it just really complicates the grief. I can't even describe it.
I don't know that there's a specific reason why it's happening here in Medicine Hat. I do know that the shock and the grief of the friends in this circle has been extensive. And so they're not even able to recover before another incident has occurred. So their grief becomes compounded and complicated by the inability to grieve. And we just simply won't ever know. Those people aren't here to speak their truth. And so even working with families that have had experiences of loss always have that question of why. And we never can answer that question. And so what we do know is hopelessness is the one main trait that will move someone from ideation to acting on that. When someone in Medicine Hat calls the crisis team, they end up calling the distress line, which is in Calgary, who then calls the hospital in Medicine Hat, who then calls the crisis worker, who then likely may be at home, who then has to come to the hospital. There's just all these extra steps. And when people are in those darkest moments, they need immediate support. If they have, just a tiny space to act in that moment, then potentially the support can be effective, but it needs to be swift.
Now in Medicine Hat, you're seeing groups being formed. It's anything. It's talking to the men, saying, talk about your feelings, go get some help, and the numbers. And obviously, people are just trying to make sure that the next young man who's thinking about this knows there are resources available.
I think Ryan felt like he was mostly alone, that other men didn't have these same feelings, that there was something wrong with him. He didn't tell me. I didn't know. I wish I would have known, that night. I would have helped him. I would have saved him.
Men don't ask each other, how's it going? They'll spend time together, but they don't necessarily have those tougher talks that are more vulnerable. As many families have said, well, I asked my loved one if they were okay, and they kept saying, I'm okay, I'm okay, I'm okay. So, what makes someone want to be open and honest in that moment? Many people who die from suicide believe that they're a burden on their family.
I promise you, you matter. You're loved. And the devastation you will leave in the wake. It's just so life-changing.
So just please reach out. I'm sure it's scary, maybe humiliating, but people care. People love them. And there's always another answer.
My condolences to all the families. While I mention these deaths, it by no means negates the worth of the residents we lost to COVID and or those that we lost while waiting, those that lost their lives while waiting for treatment delayed by COVID and overdose deaths. It is all a tragedy. The business closures have been particularly tough. Having been in business and laying awake at night with a mortgage payment I could not make, I feel immense respect for all of our businesses and all adversely affected businesses. I will not tolerate someone with a government paycheck screaming at me to close these so-called greedy self-serving businesses unless they are willing to make the same sacrifice themselves. I think I may have recited this poem last year, but it is one that makes the most sense as a metaphor for the year that we just had. It's Captain, My Captain, and it was written by Walt Whitman, and it is written about Abraham Lincoln and the Civil War. It is a celebration of winning the war, but at the unfortunate cost of the assassination of the president. As, I may be premature, but as I do see a successful end to the war that is COVID, I might be a bit premature, but we will win this. Every time I say, Captain, my captain, or father, you can think of a friend or a loved one you have lost this year. Whenever I say the ship or vessel, you can think of the city, the country, or the world. And whenever I say voyage or trip, you can think of this time period that we have spent battling this pandemic. Oh, captain, my captain, our fearful trip is done. The ship has weathered every rack. The prize we sought is won. The port is near, the bells I hear, the people all exulting, while follow eyes the steady keel, the vessel grim and daring. But oh heart, 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 the bleeding drops of red, whereon the deck my captain lies, fallen, cold and dead. Oh captain, my captain, rise up and hear the bells. Rise up, for you the flag is flung, for you the bugle trills, for you banquets and ribbon wreaths, for you the shores are crowding, for you the swaying masses, their eager faces turning. Oh, captain, dear father, this arm beneath your head, it is some dream that on the deck you've fallen cold and dead. My captain does not answer. His lips are pale and still. My father does not answer. He has no pulse nor will. The ship is anchored safe and sound, the voyage closed and done. From fearful trip, the victor ship comes in with object won. Exalt all shores and ring all bells. But I, with mournful tread, walk the deck. My captain lies, fallen, cold and dead. Thank you. Not only did the business of the city not stop, the pandemic drove the city of Medicine Hat to innovate like never before. We adapted to continue providing as many services as we could, made modifications, closed facilities, open facilities, closed facilities, canceled events, made tough choices around Canada Day and fireworks, and generally had to be the bad guy and the bearer of tough news. Impacts were so significant, they pushed the city to launch the Accelerated Financially Fit program. We changed our dividend policy to be more reflective of our current commodity realities in gas, oil, and electricity. We divested many gas wells and sold off oil assets. We introduced MHT Now, Medicine Hat Transit Now, which has been a phenomenal success. Uber buses at night, I like to call it. We were able to increase service levels while simultaneously decreasing costs. We announced $14.7 million in budget cuts, efficiencies, and savings. To put this in perspective, that would be the equivalent of Calgary cutting more than $300 million out of their budget. They did not, and instead raised property taxes to the residents because of their non-residential shortfall. Our largest union, QP, took a leadership role and settled on no wage increases. The employees recognized that their neighbors were struggling, losing their businesses and livelihoods, and they approached us as a means to do their part. It is very hard to ask your neighbors to pay you more property taxes so that you can have a wage increase while they are not answering their phone because of collection agents constantly calling. Many of our employees took voluntary early retirement. Many of our staff got on board and offered up unique ways to save money, some of them small, but in the end, they added up to significant amounts. Invest Medicine Hat, or IMH, was reformed, including consolidation and merger with other city departments. IMH 2.0 has had many wins during these troubling times. Selling Samus 7 and other land, looking for efficiency, attracting new businesses, and helping organic growth of those that were already here. Here is an IMH video.
2020 was a year of unprecedented adversity, but Medicine Hat continued to provide great value for investors and expanding businesses alike. Innovative incentives, a low-cost workforce, a business-friendly attitude, and our exceptional quality of life helped our city weather the challenges with Invest Medicine Hat at the forefront, guiding the way.
Hi, I'm Jason Melhoff, Managing Director at IMH. Medicine Hat is a wonderful place to live and work. At Invest Medicine Hat, we're here to help foster new investment opportunities. One of the ways we achieve this is by commercial and industrial business expansion or relocation. We offer a customized concierge service and work with you each step of the way through breaking ground to ribbon cutting. Our team works closely with the City of Medicine Hat to improve process and reduce red tape. Thank you for your time and watching this video, and we look forward to working with you.
We used to have a schedule and the city used to have a schedule. They never match. But now we take great care in our concierge meetings to make sure that they do match. And so we're not working with your schedule or my schedule, we're working with our schedule.
Being able to call and with an idea for a project or a solution and being met with enthusiasm and a willingness to work together is really encouraging. The city is not only saying they want to attract investment and make the city grow, they're actually doing it.
I want to talk about the reduction of red tape. We get to the truth very quickly. We get action immediately. Other municipalities declare that they're open for business, but they really haven't changed their organization to allow for that to happen effectively, which the City of Medicine Hat has.
From a land perspective, Invest Medicine Hat, where our goal is to take some complicated properties and try to simplify them. We have a large inventory of land assets, and one of the things that we really want to focus on is not competing with private development and instead collaborating with them to bring that development to the city. Our 10-20-30 program targeted at builders saw some great success, as well as our infill incentive program, a very flexible program that helps developers with some complicated infill land assets that makes them, again, more investment ready. We're looking forward to introducing more incentive programs through 2021 and beyond that will lead to those same goals.
We're just really excited for what Invest Medicine Hat is doing here in our community, providing incentives and bringing industry and business to our community. We need to provide the homes for the people that are coming in and investing in our community and just making it a great place to live. The work that Invest does is certainly great to encourage and incent those people to take a look at our community and settle in here.
We're able to then have that transparent relationship, collaborate together, and we're able to say what our goals and objectives are for a project, but also here are the city's goals and objectives and see if there's alignment. And as a developer, I don't really know what more we can ask for from a municipality.
Invest Medicine Hat is always keeping an eye on emerging market trends. We want to know where the money is going, and we want to be talking to those people making decisions about where to invest. Getting Medicine Hat in front of them as a potential place to invest in. Businesses looking to locate in an affordable city, a competitive business environment, great access to markets would want to consider investing in Medicine Hat. Everything that you need to run a business from heavy industrial all the way down to commercial, Medicine Hat's a great location to reach markets from throughout Western Canada and beyond. We're a source of information, of connections, liaison to politicians, really a one-stop shop for everything that your business needs to succeed here in Medicine Hat.
We're looking at projects in other areas, but with the level of collaboration and transparency we're getting from the Invest Medicine Hat team, council, administration, Medicine Hat is one of the places that's first on our list.
Invest Medicine Hat plays a very important role in cultivating a positive local business community. We led some very innovative projects in 2020, including the Medicine Hat Business Innovation Grant, the Shop Here Powered by Google program, and the Shop YXH.ca Marketplace.
The Shop Here program allowed over 100 businesses to build a customized website for free. The Shop YXH program then brought those businesses and others into one online marketplace, making it easy to support local.
There's nothing that makes us more happy than to support our local business community and help them succeed.
I was so excited when I heard about the shopyxh.ca website launching. It is an amazing place for businesses to be able to connect with one another, to work together, to collaborate, as well as it creates that directory feel for customers to be able to find those businesses that they're looking for.
I am absolutely thrilled to have been able to take advantage of the free programs and initiatives offered to our community small businesses this year through Invest Medicine Hat. These programs made it possible for me to expand my business to a place where I did not have to return to work after having kids, which is very important to me. Knowing that I had the tools and resources in place from these programs to not only survive but thrive in our current marketplace made the decision to stay home with our children a lot easier to make.
Invest Medicine Hat has helped businesses of all sizes discover a bright future this past year, and we're just getting started. If your business is looking to relocate or expand, contact Invest Medicine Hat and find out why our community is your best bet for a bright future.
So I decided to try something a little different this year because we are able to do some post-productions. I've almost considered this part of the speech like a eulogy. And in a eulogy, you talk about the year that was and, send the individual or the city, hopefully, to a better place. And part of a eulogy is often there's some words put to music. So I've had corporate communications do this for me.
Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember, when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever, and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December, when somebody say your name, cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got, cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your.
I hope you enjoyed that video. And with that, let's all say goodbye to 2020. Now, what do we have to look forward to in 2021? We have YXH Gateway, which we have many airside, which means runway or groundside opportunities coming to the market. Bring us your dream. I love this new sign. While I know it may seem expensive at this time, for many, it will be their very first impression of Medicine Hat. We want our visitors to think they have come to a place of opportunity. The federal and provincial governments came to us with stimulus money for projects with many criteria attached. Some of them that they must be completed by the end of the year and no increase in operating costs and could not have already been planned. Staff at City Hall are in overdrive trying to design, plan, and implement all these projects. And here are just a few of them that we have some initial rendering drawings of. We don't have all of them, and there's more than 20 projects. But here we have Athletic Park, 603 First Street, Echodale Trail Expansion, Pickleball, and there's many, many more. Some people ask me, why no pool in the South? Operating costs. Why no pedestrian bridge over the South Saskatchewan River? Time limitations. We need to execute on these projects or risk losing the money to other municipalities. We've also started working on a citizen-facing digital strategy. This fascinating innovation was partially spurred by the pandemic. COVID and other forces pushed the organization to offer accessible service. We want to focus on sustainability to customer service. Digitizing services will allow residents and business to access city services more conveniently and efficiently. So be on the lookout for a new and improved website and more online services through a mobile channel. However, you will still be able to access the city in traditional ways through telephone or in person. Also in 2021, we are embarking on a REC master plan that will hopefully answer some of your questions about the future of many of our facilities. We're still progressing on Unit 17, the new electric generation plant. We've actually just awarded another contract this morning. This is an exciting addition to our power generation. This is proceeding despite the talks of an asset sale. Unit 16, the one we just opened, has generated great results for the city, with companies like Hut 8 coming and possibly for Aurora and future industry that may be coming to the city of Medicine Hat. Having said that, we are opening up the new Northwest Industrial Area with a substantial investment in land development for new industry. This is a shift in focus from the city developing residential lands and moving into more of an patient investor mode, one that the private sector may not be interested in developing. Now, I'd like to show you something that I and the majority of council find quite exciting. For many years, we have feared our river due to flooding. Now, I wish to celebrate this wonderful natural asset. As I have said before, there is only one business on the south backing onto the South Saskatchewan River, and we aim to change that. I must stress this is only a vision. Myself and council would love to hear any feedback or ideas for improvement. This is not a planning document or a static area structure plan. It is only a first step in visioning, and I hope you enjoy it.
We love our river, we love our downtown. The development of our waterfront has the potential to provide economic development opportunities and increase our quality of life through vibrant amenity spaces that bring us together as a community. That is why waterfront development is a key City Council priority and a significant component of the newly adopted long-range MyMH Municipal Development Plan. We are pleased to share with you some of the initial thoughts regarding the opportunity for developing our waterfront. The waterfront district is comprised of prime riverfront land that extends over 1 kilometer from the library to athletic baseball park. It is an untapped opportunity, waiting for a bold vision to capitalize on one of Medicine Hat's best features, our riverfront. It is important to note not all of the existing uses and buildings in and along the corridor will be redeveloped, but they all will become more active and vibrant as the waterfront takes shape. The city, in working with residents, stakeholders, and the private sector, will look to create a dynamic and stunning public space open freely to all, along with development opportunities for those looking to have a place to live and work within the waterfront development district. Let's go into a little more detail as we explore the waterfront. Along the river, the wide, vehicle-free promenade stretches from City Hall to Maple Avenue Bridge. The promenade will provide a space to leisurely walk along the river, go for a run, or simply visit with friends. Cantilevered lookouts over the river edge and the stairs to the water will provide opportunities for relaxing in a beautiful setting while allowing direct access for water sports such as paddleboarding, kayaking, and fishing. Stairs and a hard-surfaced community square connect the river and the promenade area with Veterans Park. The community square and stairs will become the prime space for future activities and events. Whether it is an outdoor fitness class, a fun run, people watching, or a major festival, the community square can accommodate it all. With stairs that double as seating, this informal space also has the capacity to host large crowds for an outdoor summer concert experience. A constructed natural playground beside the square will allow young people to reconnect with nature and play on elements designed to mimic the natural debris and life that is left after a flood. Elements could include climbing rocks, logs, tunnels, and interaction with the slopes for potential slides and zip lines. The adjacent stairs will allow for an elevated space for parents and grandparents to watch the play unfold. Eating and drinking together next to the river's edge, with bustle all around, will come to be a favorite activity for residents and tourists. The space next to the community square will be filled with tables, chairs, umbrellas, pop-up food and drink options, and food trucks. This will be a special place to relax with friends and enjoy the mix of activity and natural river beauty. High on top of the promenade, where it has always been, is the historic Riverside Veterans Park. This is a place that our community has come to gather for over 100 years for celebrations and somber events. The potential enhancements in the park are meant to highlight the cherished aspects, such as the cenotaph, bandshell, murals, and planter beds. New, wider walkways and connections will provide barrier-free access, stunning views from multiple directions, and increased safety within the park. Capitalizing on the waterfront improvements, a market commons consisting of a series of buildings define the edge and gateway to the park. Replacing what is currently the street and edges of the park and City Hall Square, the Market Commons is envisioned as Medicine Hat's first pedestrian, paving stone, high street shopping and dining area, with up to a dozen new commercial opportunities. With wide walkways and high quality design, the Market Commons will become the gateway that links the waterfront district with the rest of downtown.
Over the next 10 to 20 years, the Waterfront District will emerge as Medicine Hat's premier destination as we look to capitalize on our most important asset, the South Saskatchewan River. At this early stage, our vision is of an urban village with room for more than 1,000 new housing units, new office space, and new retail opportunities. Assuming full build-out of a medium-density, mixed-use urban neighborhood, we anticipate the private sector will invest more than $300 million into making the Waterfront District a reality. If we look at the construction phase of the project in a little more detail, we expect that $300 million of private sector investment has the potential to generate an additional $700 million of business-to-business sales and related economic activity. This will support thousands of new jobs and contribute to Medicine Hat's financial sustainability over the long term. The South Saskatchewan River is our most important asset, and the Waterfront District is Medicine Hat's billion-dollar opportunity, which is why, beginning later this year, we will break ground on the first of many new projects designed to bring our vision to life.
Starting this spring, with grants from the provincial and federal governments, we'll break ground on three new projects as part of the Phase 1 Waterfront District. The first project, a town square, will rehabilitate the parking lot at 603 First Street, adding a permanent pop-up market and a flexible community space. In the warmer months, the community can experience a farmer's market, food trucks, concerts, sporting events, and more. In the colder months, the focus will shift to skating and holiday markets. South of City Hall, along First Street, the second stimulus project will see an addition to an existing city office building, allowing for the consolidation of various city staff currently in buildings dispersed across the city. The design will allow for future additional stories to be added as required. Lastly, the third stimulus project, located on the eastern edge of the Waterfront District, will fund upgrades to Athletic Park, home to the Medicine Hat Mavericks Baseball Club. Modernizing our athletic facilities will improve the spectator experience for both residents and visitors alike. The improvements also demonstrate the desire of the community to see this anchor facility entertain our city long into the future and become the eastern landmark of the Waterfront District. Now that we've shared our early stage concept for the Waterfront District, it's important to understand next steps in the process. The city has already started collecting information and will undertake further technical studies over the coming months and the rest of this year. Later this year, we will be breaking ground on the mentioned Phase 1 stimulus projects. We will also begin a collaborative design process with the public and stakeholder groups to take the waterfront district from ideas to development. The waterfront will be constructed in stages, likely over many years. For this project to thrive, we need your partnership and participation. If you are a resident, community organization, or developer interested in the waterfront district, stay tuned for future opportunities to get involved.
The private sector is already on board, and here's a video from New Rock. So with that, with New Rock's investment and the investment announced at Athletic Park and 603 First Street, we're already taking the first steps in the new waterfront development. In the last 7.5 years, I have stood on this stage many times, much more than I ever thought I would. This stage has been host to so many great artists, from Slash to Snoop Dogg to Pat Benatar to ABBA and Queen tributes. I have emceed award ceremonies, retirement dinners, and volunteer recognition events. This is also the stage in the same spot where I said goodbye to my best friend and brother. And now, today, for a virtual pre-recorded COVID state of the city. And I recognize this may be the last time I stand here before you. The choice to run again or not has been weighing heavily on my mind. I have tried the traditional pros and cons lists, and was no further ahead after completing them. I've discussed this with the closest loved ones in my life, and even they are split. This has been exceptionally hard on my sons, as they have had to grow up in the environment of public scrutiny, which at the age of 5 and 7, they never asked for. But they were thrust into this with no mercy. Adults that should have known better than to torment the innocent. I remember Len Mitzel, and how devastated he was when he sought re-election and was unsuccessful. But at his funeral, how thankful his family was that he was available and present for the last few years of his life. If you look around the province of Alberta, the stress of leadership during COVID, I think, has taken a toll on all the mayors, all the city councils, the premier, UCP party, Dr. Henshaw, and everyone who's involved in politics. And I'm not failing to forget the nurses and doctors and frontline workers. Of the 7 major cities in Alberta, 3 mayors have already declared that they will not seek re-election. 1 even resigned. And I actually believe there will be more. A mentor of mine once said, as mayor, you must grow in kindness. Treat everyone with respect, from the pauper to the prince. As this position has a tendency to make a person bitter, resentful, and dehumanized. If you allow yourself to fall victim to the hatred, you are done and become ineffective. My communications team has reminded me of a poem called "You Have No Enemies" by Charles Mackay. You have no enemies, you say. Alas, my friend, the boast is poor. He who has mingled in the fray of duty that the brave endure must have foes. If you have none, small is the work that you have done. You've never hit the traitor in the hip. You've never dashed the cup from perjured lip. You've never turned the wrong to right. You have been a coward in the fight. So trust me, I have enemies, and I know, because they call me and text me and tell me and tag me and email me. And while I never wanted to be, I am the villain in someone's story. Having said that, Most of them do not really know me, or the hours it takes to come to a decision and the work required to understand both sides of an issue, and are guilty of projecting their hatred of themselves onto their leaders, the psychology of mirroring. And I have learned empathy for the haters rather than to despise them, as they are forced to live in that hate every day of their lives. Therefore, as my mentor said, you must grow in kindness, and I'm trying. However, if I would have stayed in the safety and protection and peace of private life, I would never have met some of the most wonderful humans on the planet, angels that walk amongst us, people like Natasha Caravello or Selena Simmons or Jamie Rogers, the executive directors of the Women's Shelter Food Bank and Medicine Hat Community Housing. These women have sacrificed day in and day out to make our community a better and safer for all that have been called upon to do heroic work during COVID. And it is my honor to have met you. I wouldn't have otherwise. We have accomplished many, many wonderful things, and there is still work to be done. I have decided that I would like to see it through, given the opportunity. So I humbly and respectfully declare that I will run seek re-election in October, barring unforeseen circumstances. Leadership must not be about the ascension to power, to control people, but the selfless desire to make things better in the community, province, and country you love and live in. Thank you. So I humbly and respectfully declare that I will run seek re-election.
I've never had a more captive audience.
Thank you very much, Mayor Clugston, for your presentation. We always look forward to an interesting and what I call extraordinary type of comment that you make about the challenges that you faced this past year, especially with COVID, and of course, some of the future vision that you might have for the city of Medicine Hat. Thank you very much again. And ladies and gentlemen, now it is my pleasure to introduce Marcus Campbell, who is the chairman of the board of directors of the Chamber of Commerce, to present his thanks and appreciation and do a presentation to the mayor.
On behalf of the Chamber of Commerce, board of directors, our membership, and our team, thank you, Mayor Clugston, for taking the time to speak with us today. The Chamber continues to have a strong working relationship with the city, and we look forward to the continued conversations in making progress on our collective priorities. As a token of our appreciation, I'd like to present you with a donation made in your name to a local charity of your choice. Mayor Clugston has chosen the Medicine Hat District Health Foundation. On behalf of the Chamber of Commerce, we want to thank each of you for attending and supporting this annual event. We know it looks a little different this year, but we also recognize how important it is to deliver this annual address, particularly given the challenges we've all experienced over the last year. And it's an opportunity for us to look forward and shape how we will build our future. Our gratitude goes out to the Kiwanis Club, as always, for providing us this opportunity. And we always enjoy working with them and putting on this important and informative event. It's been a challenging year. And as a chamber, we remain committed to supporting and encouraging a strengthened and vibrant economy in our region through our connections, our support, and our influence. Our priorities are shaped by you, our members. It's the issues, challenges, and opportunities that you bring to us that shape our work in order for us to use our collective voice for the benefit of not only our members, but our entire business community as a whole. This particular event allows us to connect our business community to our city, hear stories of success, opportunities, and challenges for our region, and gather insight as to how we can move forward together. By understanding the priorities of our city and those of our business community, we can shape the next steps for the coming year. To keep connected and up to date with all the business news, events, and more, check out our website at medicinehatchamber.com and be sure to continue to use our COVID-19 information page and subscribe to our weekly e-newsletter through our publications and media page. Also, a reminder that the State of the City address will be broadcast on every Shaw cable network for the next 2 months. Check your channel programming guide for airtimes and dates. Finally, we just want you all to remember that we're here for you, and we encourage you to connect with our team. We got one of the best teams around. And visit our website and connect with us on our social media feeds. Thank you to everybody for your attendance today, and enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you very much, Marcus. We appreciate your involvement as the Chamber of Commerce and being a partner with our Kiwanis Club. And now it's my pleasure to introduce to you again the president of the Kiwanis Club of Medicine Hat, Derek Ironside, who will also have some words of thanks and make a presentation as well.
Thank you. It is my privilege to deliver the thank you to our partners for this event. I would like to very graciously thank the Chamber of Commerce and the City of Medicine Hat for the tremendous effort that has gone into planning and carrying out this event. This was no small task. It just seemed that every step of the way, and there were many steps, our planning committee was having to change the way that things were going to be done for one reason or other. Most of those changes were as a result of the fact that we are in the middle of a deadly pandemic, and it was all about abiding by public health directives and keeping everyone safe. Kiwanis clubs, such as the Kiwanis Club of Medicine Hat, of which I am the president and a member, focus on changing the world by serving children, one child and one community at a time. Now I would like to present this check in the amount of $200 to Mayor Clugston that he would like donated to the Medicine Hat and District Health Foundation.
Thank you for this very kind gift and the opportunity to speak at your event. Through the pandemic, the Medicine Hat District Health Foundation continues to raise funds to support and enhance local health care for residents of southeastern Alberta. I want to take this opportunity to highlight and thank our great community for all they've done to support our healthcare heroes. Many of our healthcare professionals have had their worlds turned upside down, and each day brings new challenges and adventures. The Health Foundation has been honored to share with them your positive words of support, gifts, and Christmas cards, which have helped lift their spirits as they continue the daily fight to keep our community healthy. Please continue to do your part by wearing your mask and staying home when you can. Thanks again, and have a great day.
I want to take this opportunity to thank a few people along the way, and that, first of all, Mayor Ted Clugston. Thank you very much for your comments and for your clarification of the vision for the future and what has been accomplished, especially during this tough COVID times. And while we're speaking of COVID, I know you've heard enough about it over the months, but at the same time, we want to thank those people who work in the front lines. It's been a tremendous job to be there, to be ready to help wherever they can. And then all the people in the community as well who have had some way, the first responders, our police and ambulance, our firemen, and the various organizations, the schools, the teachers, and their students, how they've been coping with all of this. It just has been fantastic. I want to thank the Chamber of Commerce for being a partner with us, and the Kiwanis Club of Medicine Hat for their efforts to host this event itself. We look forward, by the way, to a 2022 where we'll have a brand new in-person event. And so for all of you, have a good time, a good day, and stay safe, stay well, because if we all follow the guidelines, by the way, in terms of wearing a mask and or social distancing and staying away from gatherings in backyards and in homes, until the guidelines are changed, we'll win this game. So thank you again, Heather Bach, for being the recipient of the donation that goes charity through Mayor Ted Clugston, and for all. And then let us close off by asking Randy Ferry to come back and lead us in God Save the Queen.
God save our gracious queen, long live our noble queen, God save the queen. Send her victorious, happy and glorious, long to reign over us, God save the queen.